Hey, all you reptile enthusiasts out there, this is the Dragon Whisperer, and this is Gandalf, and this is another video for the channel. In this video, we're going to be highlighting Gandalf here, my Panther Chameleon, and we're going to be going over all the basics to care of Panther Chameleons. So, Mr. Gandalf here kind of came to me in an unusual way. I consider him a rescue, even though I paid for Gandalf, because Gandalf was at a local Petco that I go often for feeders. And Gandalf was kept in a huge enclosure in the middle of the store in a wide open spot. He was subjected to people coming up to his tank, tapping on his glass, trying to get his attention all the time. It was a glass enclosure with very poor ventilation. And so the employees of Petco knew that I came in there all the time. They see me probably twice a week. They knew about my channel. They knew about what I'm doing here at the rescue and all the other reptiles I take care of. So they were asking $400 for Gandalf. And the management cut me a deal and sold me Gandalf for $150 because they knew I would give it a good home. The poor guy was constantly being asked to be taken out of his enclosure by customers that feigned interest in buying him. And, you know, due to store policy, the employees would have to get him out, let the customers check him out. And Gandalf was just always being stressed out. And not only that, but being in the big glass enclosure with poor ventilation, and people trying to mess with him all the time, I felt very bad for Gandalf and felt like he needed a much better home. So I consider Gandalf a rescue, even though I did pay for him. I brought him home here to the rescue, and I built him a nice, beautiful, custom-made enclosure. I'll be showing you guys that in the video. And Gandalf has been doing lovely here. He has turned into a great, socialized, very calm guy who doesn't stress very easy at all now. And he really enjoys his life here, I believe, at the rescue. So me and Gandalf are going to be getting straight into the video, you guys. I hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to smash that like button when you get through watching. Ring that notification bell. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, you guys, please subscribe. It's the best thing you guys can do to help support the channel and what I do here at the rescue. So hope you guys enjoy the video. And here we go. Okay, you guys, you can't really see him super well right now, but he is pretty dark right now. I'm going to try to get the camera a little closer, and if you guys can see right there, he is a pretty dark, he's really green, and as you can see, his tail's back there,
Nice execution.
You're doing terrific.
His tail back there is pretty purple. That's pretty dark and kind of a pretty, not super stressed, but a fairly stressful look for Mr. Gandalf. That's when he's not super, super happy. He exhibits those type of colors. But you'll see right here. Now, chameleons can't hear very well at all. They don't even really have ears, but they can detect low vibrations. So when I do talk to Gandalf, I try to use a really, really low, "Hey, Gandalf. How's it going, buddy? What you doing, big guy? Hey, pretty boy. Hey, pretty boy. Hey, Mr. Gandalf."
Wait, what are you doing? Listen to me.
Look, you love this woman, don't you?
Yes.
You want to hold her?
Yes.
Please her?
Yes.
Then you got to try a little panda man.
It takes a lot of coaxing. It takes a delicate hand and a lot of time and patience to socialize and work with your Panther Chameleon. And that is if and only if he takes to it, because you'll be able to notice if it's really stressing him out, he will run away from you. He will try his best to get away from you. And I will show you the behavior of another chameleon that a friend of mine owns, and you'll be able to see how a chameleon acts when he wants nothing at all to do with you. Now, Gandalf right here is not coming towards me, which unfortunately a lot of my animals don't like to perform from the camera. But, oh, actually, I'm wrong. Mr. Gandalf is just choosing his own method. As you will see, chameleons, they're, like I said, solitary creatures. They love to hide. They're not really social. They don't like to really be out in the open, but see, Mr. Gandalf, "Hey, buddy." Mr. Gandalf loves his daddy, and you are super, super lucky. I'm like this kid right here.
Open this.
because when you have a chameleon that will come out of his enclosure and want to interact with you like this, Mr. Chameleon does not run away from me, and he likes his dad. And as you can already see, he's developing some yellows. I hope that's showing up good on camera. He's developing some yellow. His deep dark reds are turning more orange. That dark purplish color on his tail is starting to turn into a bright orange. But his colors will completely change as his moods change. A lot of people think chameleons change their colors to blend in their surroundings. That's kind of a wives' tale or misinformation. Their colors more as like a crested gecko. It changes based on humidity and mood. But I am very, very lucky. You guys don't be expecting your panther chameleon to behave like this. A lot of these guys don't ever want to be touched. And even if you spend weeks and months trying to socialize them, it could be kind of like this, or it could be a lot different. You could spend a long time trying to socialize your panther chameleon and get him to like you, come to his cage, try to talk to him every day, tongue feed him, do all the things to bond with him that people say. But you have to understand that all those activities are going to stress him out at first, and you have to make the call as to whether you are stressing your panther chameleon out to the point that it's not worth trying to have that relationship with him. Before you get a panther chameleon, you need to understand that you may never have a panther chameleon like this. And the work trying to get him to be this way, to tame him down and socialize him, may just stress him out to the point where you're doing him more harm than you're doing good, just to try to satisfy your need to have a one-on-one relationship with the animal. This is highly unusual, you guys. When you watch the video, him climbing out to me like this when I open the door, and he always does that. That's very unusual. That is not normal chameleon behavior. But like I said, the situation that Gandalf was in his early months was unusual, and I'm very lucky that I was able to rescue him from that situation. And as you guys can see, Gandalf loves climbing on me, and he loves every time I open the door, he comes straight to his big daddy and wants to hang out and climb, sits with me. He loves to watch TV. A lot of times he'll be right here on the front part of his cage facing the television, especially when I'm watching music videos and cleaning up tanks. So we're going to put Gandalf back here and get to some other stuff in the video. Here you go, bud. I know you're not going to want to go back. I know you're not going to want to go back. There you go, big boy.
You know what? I don't know who called it the comfort zone, but I'm pretty sure they call it that, because everything inside that zone's good and comfy. So once you get outside of that zone, fuck.
Well, that's when things can get a bit dicey.
Can you feel the tension in the air right now? I know I can.
Okay, now, although this is a different species, you guys, this is a veiled chameleon, as you can see by that big tight helmet type of structure on top of his head. But Mr. Chameleon here is one of my buddy's reptiles, and as you can see, his temperament is quite different from Gandalf's. And a lot of panther chameleons can have a similar temperament to this guy. And as you can see here, as I get close to Mr. Chameleon, he will flatten his body a lot of the times, and oftentimes he will hiss and let you know that he does not appreciate you being around him at all. But his temperament, he does not like to be handled, he does not like to be touched. See, there he's eyeballing my fingers,
and this guy really does not like to be handled. If I try to pick him up, he will definitely not try to get hold of my fingers. He is going to try his best to get away from me and flee the scene. He does not like really much interaction. He's definitely more of a solitary type of a guy, and he definitely enjoys his space. And he has this nice big enclosure, which got a little bit of Christmas decorations in it now. But he has a big, nice enclosure, and he really enjoys having all the space, but he does not like, this is not a guy who's really gonna, now his owner, he can come to the cage door, and this guy will come to him, but most people, and his mother, Draven's mom, has a pretty good relationship with this guy, but he typically really doesn't like anybody else, and it really kind of stresses him out anytime that anybody wants to interact with him, because he really just wants to be left alone. And that's typically the personality you're going to encounter with chameleons. Now, for an enclosure size, for females, they're not going to get quite as big as males, so you can get away with 24 by 24 by 36. And if you have a baby or a hatchling, you can get away with an 18 by 18 by 24. And if you have a male, you're going to want a minimum of 24 by 24 by 48. But obviously, in all these situations, bigger is better. But screen is the big deal. These guys require a lot of ventilation. Some people even use computer fans on the top or on the sides. I have an oscillating fan that I sit near Gandalf's cage every couple days to make sure he's getting great airflow. But these guys require airflow. They can have respiratory problems really easy. So you definitely want a screen cage, not glass. These guys originate in northern and coastal areas of Madagascar, but primarily the coastal lowlands. This like a wet, low areas. Even though they live up in the trees, they live in the lowland areas of the island. Males can live 5 to 7 years. Females are only going to live 2 to 3 years, because the females lay between 5 and 8 clutches every year, whether they're bred or not, and those clutches can contain 12 to 30 eggs. So you're talking about 12 to 30 plus eggs 5 to 8 times a year, whether they breed or not. That's super taxing on their body. So the females, if they live 3 years, you're lucky. But a lot of times they can pass away after 2 years because that egg production is so taxing on their body. These are solitary, territorial creatures. They stress very easily, typically do not like to be handled. If you get a panther chameleon and you can't wait for your friends to come over because it's so incredibly beautiful for you to take it out of its cage and show it off, you may end up feeling like this guy right here. Because they may not want to come to you. They may run to the back corner. They may hide. They may try their best to climb away from you, and then you're just going to be embarrassed and upset. So, like I've said before, panther chameleons do not necessarily like to be handled, and even if you try to socialize it,
they still may not put up with it. Now, panther chameleons will not drink out of standing water, so you want to make sure you have a dripper system, which I'll show you one of those later in the video, or a misting system. I have this Thrive system, which I highly recommend. You can set it for different intervals, whether you want it 3, 6, 12, 1, 3, 6, 12 hours, and then 15, 30, 45 seconds or a minute misting. The only complaint I have about this, it has a pretty large reservoir. It lasts a couple days, but this thing is attached to my timer, and even though it's on at night, when the timer goes off in the morning, I have to turn it back on by pushing this button. When the timer comes on, it does not come on automatically by itself, which is one drawback. These guys definitely need UVB. I would actually rather have the full bar across the top, but due to COVID and other things right now, I just financially can't afford the big bar like I have on a lot of my other tanks. Hopefully I will get that, but right now Gandalf spends the majority of his time in his basking area and up high, and I know he's getting a lot of that UVB. And I do have the coil, which is not the best, guys. I know, don't kill me in the comments. He will be getting a T18 18 inch bar to go all the way across, or maybe a 20 inch bar light to go all the way across soon. So his enclosure has a little clasp here. I'm going to open it up and show you guys. Also, you want to give these guys lots and lots of things to climb on, lots of things to hide on. He has a lot of bamboo and vines. And also, I have built in these feeding ledges so that I can put bowls of superworms or little dishes of roaches on these feeding platforms, and Gandalf can eat off of those. Those are a great addition. And here is the misting system mounted. Now, when Gandalf's misting system goes off, I'll show you guys a little small demonstration here, and it pretty much just creates a rain type of system that goes off inside of Gandalf's enclosure, provides nice droplets of water on a lot of the foliage and the leaves, drips down through the enclosure, and gives Gandalf lots of opportunities to drink. I have it set now to go off 2 or 3 times a day. He is such a beautiful, amazing guy. And substrate for these guys, I really don't recommend a substrate. I use these 2 aluminum pans and change out the paper towels every couple of days. And I have a fake linoleum type waterproof floor on the bottom of his enclosure, because it does get wet because of the misting, to keep the wood from warping or getting rotten. But you can use, if you want to go bioactive, you can use eco earth or peat moss or organic soil. But insects or anything like that you're going to put in there are going to hide, and it's just going to get dirty really easy. On a side note, this is what they're putting. Looks like, similar to a lot of reptiles. It's going to be a urate type of a log, for better lack of a better word, and then a white urate at the end, or a brown feces, excuse me, and then a white urate there at the end to let you know they're getting pretty of hydration. That is what their urine looks like. It is not liquid. It's going to be a white type of toothpaste looking substance. But once again, plenty of hides, logs, leaves. Most of it is zip tied to the outside of the enclosure. And then, like I said, definitely UVB, high intensity UVB. Humidity inside their enclosure, you want it to be 60 to 80%. That's why I have the misting system that goes off regularly. So 60 to 80% for their humidity. And you want to provide plenty of enrichment. Like I said, that's what those branches and all, you want plenty of places for these guys to hide. Temperatures, you want a gradient of 70 from the low end to 90 at the top of the enclosure where his basking area is. And for a basking area, you want 90 to 95 degrees. You can go up to 100 degrees if the enclosure is big enough so that temperature doesn't radiate out too much and overheat the enclosure. But Gandalf has this wonderful basking area right here on this bamboo, right under his basking light. That's where he really likes to sit and perch. And that way he can look at his bugs that are usually in his bowl right there on his little feeding platform over here in the corner. That's where his bugs are usually sitting, and he'll be sitting right up there watching them, and then he'll climb down and eat them. He's probably getting a little annoyed by the camera now, so he's going to his little hiding spot in the back corner of the cage. And like I said, Gandalf is in a room with about 30 other reptiles, and he has a view of a lot of those. A lot of the bearded dragons are straight across from him, but because he was so socialized and interacted with so much in his former situation, it really doesn't seem to stress Gandalf out. And if it does, does, he can always go back there in the back corner, or any, he has plenty of places inside of his enclosure that he can get behind and hide and feel really safe. So that covers the lighting, definitely UVB, basking temperatures. You want your lighting to be on a 10 to 14 hour cycle. These guys, you can tell they're dimorphic as far as sexing, because the males are always going to be brightly colored. And these guys come in a lot of morphs. Gandalf here is an ambalobe, but they, a lot of the morphs like the Umbajas and the Sambavas, I don't know if I'm saying that correctly, they can be like almost completely blue and just a variety of shades of blue. They don't really get the reds. And then you have other morphs that are completely red and dominated by red colors. The ambalobes to me are the prettiest because they have the broadest range of the most colors. They can have the blues, the reds, the greens, the yellows, the oranges. To me, they have the most variety of colors. As far as the different morphs between the different species of chameleons. And also with these guys feeding, these guys like crickets, they like superworms. I'm going to include some clips in the video of Gandalf eating. Usually he'll eat off the tongs for me, but a lot of times he'll just eat right out of his bowls. And for food, they also like silkworms, hornworms, waxworms. They like locusts. They really love baby mantids. Like baby praying mantises is one of their favorite things in the wild. Locusts. They can eat 30 to 40 insects per week. Definitely want to make sure you're gut loading. They will eat vegetables in the wild for hydration, but in captivity, I've never heard of anybody getting them to eat. And since they don't have ears, like I described in another part of the video, they can only really hear like low vibrations. So like loud noises and stuff, from what I've heard, typically don't bother them, but maybe the vibrations from the noises can. But I listen to loud music in the room and play loud TV shows and movies, and Gandalf does not seem to mind. Babies should poop every day or at least every other day. Adults usually once or twice a week. And then shedding. When these guys shed, they usually will do it pretty quickly, but sometimes they can get stuck shed, particularly on their toes. They have these little mitts with two fingers on one side, three on the other, just like a little five-fingered hand, just two on one side, three on the other. And but they have difficulty sometimes cleaning their eyes. So I've also had difficulty with Gandalf cleaning his eyes. So even with the misting system, sometimes these guys take a minute or two of water hitting their eyes for them to realize, oh, this is the time that it's like raining, or I need this time to wash my eyes, because their eyes are kind of set in the sockets there. So they can be kind of stubborn sometimes, but that's something you need to do. And I've even heard of people taking their chameleon and putting it in the shower with them, throwing their swim trunks on and throwing this guy in the shower with them. And after 2 or 3 minutes of cool water running on them, they finally get the picture, and they will actually kind of squint and move those eyes all around in a circle, and they'll actually be cleaning out the inside of those eye sockets. So that's something you want to make sure you do with your chameleon at least once a week. Mist him down for a good couple of minutes until you see him moving those eyes around in the sockets, and that way you'll know he is cleaning the inside of those eye shoots out really good. So that's important with your chameleon. Make sure he's getting those eyes cleaned out with a really heavy misting. You know, you don't want to spray it directly in his eyes, but you do want the water to be hitting his face so he can get water in those eye sockets. Their color change is usually a sign of their stress. If they're really brightly colored, or their colors are lighter, then that means they're pretty calm right now. Gandalf is pretty calm. When he gets really excited, he'll turn really dark green. That stripe will get kind of dark blue, and he'll get really almost purple where he is red. And when he's not stressed, he's more of a yellowish green, and he's more orange, and that stripe will be really bright white. But that's a good sign that the mood of your chameleon, the color he's displaying. So like I said, big open enclosure. We went over enclosure size, we went over temperatures, we went over food, we went over humidity. And just like I said, you can try every day to come to your chameleon's enclosure, talk to him, open the door, and see if he wants to come out. If he doesn't at first, what you can try to do is place your hand under his front arms and kind of leverage him off of whatever he's on, and that will give him the opportunity to get a hold of you and decide if he wants to come and play with you. But see, like right now, Gandalf's thinking about it. He was looking at the branch. Do I want to go back in my house or do I want to go hang out with Dad? And, oh, is he going to shun me? Yep, he's close to his bedtime, guys. It's just about time for his lights to turn off. So even though earlier he came right out and wanted to play with Dad, right now he said, nope, I know it's time for bed. I want to chill in my house. But if I did want to interact with him, that's how you would pick him up. Put your fingers right under his front legs and kind of give him no choice but to climb on you. And then you can see if he chooses to continue to climb on you. But if he decides he wants to stay in his home and he doesn't want anything to do with you, then that's what you need to let him do. Because taking him out and holding him against his wishes is only going to stress him out. And if you get enjoyment as the owner of a reptile by stressing your animal out, then you definitely shouldn't be a reptile owner.
That's not how it works. Now, how do you know how it works? Back it off, okay? I'm interviewing you.
No, you said that I'd be conducting the interview when I walked in here. Now, exactly how much pot did you smoke?
If you happen to get one of these guys that does like to be interacted with and does like to be held and does like to be taken out of his enclosure, then you can consider yourself like you won the lottery and you're very, very, very lucky, because typically that is not the case with these guys. So that's Mr. Gandalf. That's your basics on care. And this is stuff you need to monitor every single day, you guys. If the Baskin bulb goes out, if he gets cold for one day, he can get sick and cause him to have respiratory issues and crash and die. These guys, if they do get sick, if they do develop issues, they can die in a matter of 48, 72 hours. You don't have a lot of time with these guys. See, he's starting to get stressed a little bit. He knows I'm still looking at him and talking to him. And those eyes that can look two different directions are so amazing. He's starting to get some blues in his vertical striping there. And look how slow that back leg is moving. But these guys are amazing creatures. I do encourage you to add one to your collection if you think you can maintain the parameters and give it a good home. If not, please don't get a Panther Chameleon. They don't deserve to be something that people get just because they're beautiful and they want to hold and show off to their friends, because that's not... Oh, camera, come on, please focus. That is not the kind of lifestyle that these guys appreciate, and that's not something that's going to give them a good life. And ultimately, it's about the reptile. It's not about you as the reptile keeper.
Now, Mr. Chameleon has a dripper system, which is one way you can go to provide your hydration, because like I said, they will not drink from standing water. So this is a thing, and you can make one yourself. It has a little tube that you can put inside the enclosure anywhere you need to, and then a little valve that will adjust the rate of the drip. Okay, you guys, once again, this is the Dragon Whisperer, and I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I really hope you guys enjoyed getting to meet Gandalf, and I hope you learned a little bit about Panther Chameleons and increased your knowledge of their husbandry and your love of this species. I think they're one of the most beautiful animals on the face of the planet. Incredible, beautiful, super smart. So I hope you guys will smash that like button, ring that notification bell, and if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. That's the best thing you can possibly do for the channel and for what I do here at The Rescue. So, me and Gandalf appreciate you guys watching. Thanks so much. Hope to see you in the future. Hit me up on my website if you're interested in adding a crested gecko or gargoyle gecko to your collection. I'll be putting that up here in the corner. And you guys also, if you have any questions about the care of your animals or anything you've seen here on the video, please hit me up on my Instagram. I'll have that in the bottom. And you guys, please hit up the comment section. I know a lot of YouTubers are too big to respond to people, but I respond to every single person who comments in my videos. Sorry about that. My lights just went off here in the Dragon Keep. So if you guys comment in the section, I will definitely respond to you guys. Appreciate everything you guys do. I'm the Dragon Whisperer, and I'm out.